Hi everyone, my name is Seema. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a Queer Eye update. If you don't know what that is, it's a series I've been doing on my channel for a little over a year now, where I basically just look at my life and every month just try to like improve it little by little based on the parameters set on Queer Eye by the five guys on the show. And if you want to learn more about it, the playlist for those videos should be popping up somewhere on your screen. So today's video is probably going to be a shorter one than usual. I don't have a whole lot of updates. Today is October 5th. September was like an interesting month because I feel like I had I was gone for about 8 or 9 days. Well, it was technically like I was actually like actively gone for a week, but including the day I left and the day I got back, it ended up taking up more like 9 days of my time was just like being away in Winnipeg and also travel time. And then I also just like spent a lot of time before and after kind of like prepping. And then like, I almost feel like when you go on vacation, you need like a vacation after your vacation to like recover from your vacation. So it kind of like that whole thing sort of controlled the month for me. So I haven't got a whole lot to say that's unrelated to that. So let's just start with Bobby as usual. So he's like my house and the living in situation. I don't know if you can tell, but you can see one of the posters in the background. I have put up those posters last month that I said I wanted to do. There's a whole bunch of new things on my walls, which is very fun. It's very cool. It's, I don't know, it's taking me back to university, but like not in a bad way, because I really do feel like, I don't know, I'm very nostalgic for university these days, and I really miss my dorm room. So I kind of like having stuff on the walls again. I did a lot of this today, but I feel like my organizing has been kind of off this month because again, I still haven't been able to like get back into the routine of doing tasks and TV. I feel like I've only had like a couple, like one or two sessions of it this month. And that's like less than I would like, because I like to do it like ideally like at least once a week. So I feel like my environment has been kind of thrown for a loop, but I feel like today I actually got a lot of it in order. So that's kind of something I want to continue doing going forward. I know I've been saying this for like months, but I still haven't emptied those boxes by the door. So that was a goal that I did not accomplish that I can hopefully accomplish this month in October, fingers crossed. I also said I want to figure out like a way to store both my earrings and my scrunchies, because right now they just kind of like live on my desk and it takes up some space, but I haven't actually like looked into that any deeper. So I still want to do that. And I think that's it. Yeah, my big tasks for October are literally just emptying the boxes and just keeping my environment clean and trying to stay on top of things in a way that I feel like I wasn't able to do in September. Moving up to Anthony, so like food and drink and stuff. I'm still not hydrated, but we're just gonna move on past that. I know I said I wanted to try some new recipes, and I did do one thing that was kind of new. I threw together some chicken and okra and some other vegetables that I had, and I added some like pomegranate molasses, and I kind of like just like did my own like recipe. I sort of just made it up in my head, and that turned out really, really good. So I think I need to just trust myself a little bit more in terms of like improvising and not just sticking to the same stuff, or not necessarily like, if I'm not sticking to the same three things that I'm good at, not feeling like I have to have a recipe in order to try new things. If like I'm just very afraid of like fucking up and then wasting food or making something I don't like. But I feel like more often than not, like I know the principles of like what things taste good together. And so I should probably just trust myself more, or trust like my ability to gauge how much of something I need to add to something for it to be the correct amount and for it to taste good. And yeah, the veggie boxes have been great. Again, they force me to eat things outside of my normal comfort zone. Like today I made this very cool eggplant. I just had a lot of eggplant because I've gone eggplant I think like 2 weeks in a row. So I had a lot of eggplant, and I made this like eggplant rice vinegar, scallion, ginger, like stir fry thing that I just had on the side with my salmon today. And that was really good. And I've literally never bought rice vinegar before. I've never used it before. So that was kind of a fun new thing to try. And I ended up really liking it. Like it was not a flavor profile I would have like naturally come up with, but I really liked it. So I did just say I want to try things without recipes more, but also I think if I want to do recipes, I want to try to pick some more recipes that are kind of outside of my normal comfort zone, which is a thing I have been doing, and I want to just like keep doing it. I did get back from a trip, and I was kind of like, well, I just kind of ate like how I wanted to when I was in Winnipeg, which is something I said I was going to do. And then I got back and I was kind of like in a weird funk like in the week after that too. But today I woke up kind of like on like feeling like I could just get back on track again. And I ate like a pretty healthy day, and I'm feeling very good about it. So I think I just want to keep that going, just like getting back into my routines. I know Thanksgiving is coming up, and then I'm also going on another trip in October to visit my friend Becca. Hi Becca, if you're watching this. So I feel like those are going to be other days where I'm just going to be eating whatever. But I think as long as I kind of bounce back in the way I would like to think I can, then it should be fine. And I also have been ordering Kaizen. Is like a brand that does like protein powders and stuff, but they also have this meal replacement shake. And I was talking to the dietitian from the program I was in, and she was like, they're very similar to the program shake. So if you wanted to, like not obviously to just like eat all the time, but if you wanted to have some like backup shakes, those are an option. So I think I might like order some and do like a day or two of just like that to sort of like reset not my body, because again, I don't believe like detox is like in the way that like influencers try to sell you like weird liquids to detox, but just like in terms of like a mental reset, I think that would be really helpful. Because again, I feel like when I came off of my all shakes, I was more appreciative of like just like regular food, like whole wheat bread and broccoli and shit. And I feel like once you have like a week of just like going to restaurants and eating out, you kind of like your taste buds like adjust to that. And so having to like a reset to like remind me that like whole wheat bread is tasty would be like a good thing. But I haven't fully decided if I'm gonna do that yet. Depends on how this next like week goes, I think. Cause like I said, today was good. So if I can just stick to like how I was today, then that might not even be necessary, but it's one of those things I might end up doing. I had a lot of really good food in Winnipeg. I had a really good donut. I had bison, which I've never had before. I'm just really, like, Winnipeg is a really good food scene. Like, there was a lot of places I ate that were really good, and there were a lot of places I wanted to go that I just, like, did not have time to go to. So, like, when I go back, because I do want to go back, I still have, like, a list of places I want to go eat. So, yeah. Highly recommend the Winnipeg food scene. It's a banger. Very good. I think that's it on the Antony front. I think my goals are just, like, reset and just keep eating well, drink more water, try new recipes. Same old, same old. Moving on to tan. So tan is just like fashion and appearances and whatever. I've been starting to delve into like spooky season and just like more fall tones, dark tones, fall nail polish. I have this beautiful nail polish called, it's called Frog Prince by Light Slacker. And then also look at my earrings, look how cute these are. They are little coffins and one of them is black and one of them is white and they have like the matching little hearts on them. This is so funny because I didn't get these for this explicit purpose, but I feel like this would be really fun to wear with my Unus Honest like split black and white hoodie, because Unus Honest coffins were a heavy theme. I haven't thought about Unus Honest in a while, but I miss it. That was a fun web show. Anyways, sorry, off topic. But yeah, I've been really getting into my fall things. I did find a bunch of stuff that I had gotten over the course of quarantine from Torrid and then not worn, and now they're like too small for me, and they still have tags on, and I didn't have the receipt or anything, so I wasn't expecting to get everything back like the prices I paid for it, but I'd go to the store and return them for store credit, and I used the store credit to get myself some PJs, but also these really nice like heeled boots that I love, and I think are really, I've been wearing them around the house just to make sure they're comfortable before I wear them outside. Like, you know, some shoes you put them on and they're comfortable, but then you wear them for like longer than 10 minutes and they like are awful. These seem to not be like that. Like, they seem really comfortable so far. Like, I don't know if they're like for distance running or anything, but just like walking around the house and wearing them for a couple hours, they've been like really good. So that was a win that I'm very excited about. And I like that I didn't have to really spend money on it, because it was like all money that I had already spent and just got back in store credit, and instead like freed up space in my wardrobe for things that I wasn't gonna wear because they were just too big on me now or like looked weird. The other thing is, and I'm gonna count this in the fashion category because it's very important to me, I think I finally settled on my Halloween costumes. I'm not gonna say what they are, but I am very excited for them. So I'm actually doing two this year. One because I'm doing a group costume with my roommates, and then one just to stick to the theme that I think I said this last month too, that I wanna stick to the theme that I've been doing year after year. But I've actually finally settled on it. It's gonna be less intricate this time around. Both of those costumes are kind of like, they're nothing like extravagant in terms of like what the characters wear or like the makeup that would entail, but I think that's okay. Like, the one part of having to do extravagant costumes year after year was a lot of it was motivated by my own competitive nature and the fact that we had costume contests at work, and I haven't actually heard anything about that at my new work. I don't know if that's the kind of atmosphere that they foster at the new place I work. So I'm less invested in winning, and I also don't have like a winning streak to maintain, so it's like I don't feel the need to do something like over the top. Like, I'm still aiming for accuracy, but I feel like people like accuracy with a character that's like heavily makeuped and has a very specific look versus accuracy with kind of a normie character, people will like obviously value one over the other. And so I think it's harder to win a costume contest if you're like comic accurate to like, or like animation accurate to like Arthur the Aardvark, because he just wears like a yellow shirt and blue pants, right? Versus like if you're like cartoon accurate to like Elsa from Frozen. So I think people who get excited for Halloween costumes are gonna be a little bit disappointed, because this year's are both kind of normie, but I'm also very excited to do both. I think they're gonna be like hilarious. I am very excited to do both of those things. Yeah. And Luna's gonna be part of the group costume, so that's very exciting. But yeah, I'm excited for Halloween, which I'm counting as fashion. Fashion's been fine. On the fall front, I want to really commit to my favorite fall outfits, which I have several of, and I want to really pull them out once the weather's still too hot. Like, that's the frustrating thing, is I keep wanting to like put on the fall outfits like properly, and I keep being like, okay, well, I guess it's another day of shorts or another day of skirts, because it's still not quite cool enough for me to be layering, which is frustrating, or like wearing sweaters. Like, I don't feel comfortable wearing sweaters, because it's like at some point in the day it's going to like be above 15 degrees and I'm going to be too hot in my sweater. So it's just an annoying season still. But looking forward for the continuation of fall weather, I think October is finally going to be the month where I can like whip out the stuff I want to whip out, you know? Moving on to Jonathan Van Ness, so like grooming and makeup, etc. One thing that's been great is it's officially fall, so I've been doing a lot of fall makeup, spooky makeup. I've already like gotten full swing in the spooky season makeup. I'm very excited to do more of that, like more like dark eyes, smoky eyes, heavy eyeliner, darker tones, vampire tones. I'm gonna start pulling out the red lip more because I feel like I haven't red lipped. I feel like I've only worn a red lip like twice this year, which is like abhorrent to me. Like I wanna regularly red lip now that it's, I don't know, vampy season. You know what I mean? I need to get my brows done, which I will probably do next week, but that's been on my mind. I didn't really do them before Winnipeg and they've, because they were kind of fine then, but now they've kind of grown out and the unibrow is making an appearance, the underbrow is making an appearance. I wanna clean that shit up before Halloween, especially because I feel like both of my characters have very, very specific eyebrows, I would say. So I want to make sure I can do both of them justice, although I can never do like the covering up your eyebrows. I tried that for Ursula, I tried that for Cruella. It's not a thing that can happen with my eyebrows. Like I'm sure they're out there like Persian drag queens, but if they are, I power to them because I don't know how they cover their brows, because like I've looked at tutorials and I've tried to do it. They can't be contained. I don't know how. Like if anyone wants to try to do them on me or teach me how to do it, please do, because I would love to learn how to cover my eyebrows for costume purposes, but I cannot do it. Teeth brushing has been pretty good, like I said. I was in a bit of a slump after Winnipeg just in general because my mental health was like really bad, and that kind of like was a dip, but past couple days it's been sort of back up, so it's been good. So I had like a little bit of like a, I don't want to call it a relapse, that's very dramatic, but I did have like a downturn, but now we're back on the upwards trajectory, so that's good. So we're just gonna keep that going. My hair has kind of been like, I don't know if you can tell, it's very frizzy right now, and I've been sort of just like not happy with it. I think it's because I've been out of some of my normal stuff that I want to use, and I've been using just other stuff that I want to finish because I want to free up space in my bathroom, and so my hair just is like feeling weighed down and not as curly as I would like. And then also I feel like just in terms of like just the maintenance part of it, that's like my own doing, like how I scrunch it or how I like put it up after showers or like clipping it, I feel like I've kind of slacked off a little bit in that department too. I feel like when I first really got into the curly girl journey, I was like very like militant about making sure I did all the steps, and now I've kind of like gotten lazy about it, which is like fine, it's not a big deal, but it also like then my hair gets frizzy, and then I'm like, why is my hair so poofy and frizzy and not like pretty like defined curls like I had gotten used to? And it's because I feel like I'm just putting in less effort, so I kind of want to make sure I don't know, really look into it and like reset what I need to reset and get back into it, because yeah, it's feeling very weighed down and not as like distinctly curly as I would like it to be. So that's what I'm working on next month. That's it on the front of everybody else. I feel like my sentences are not coming out properly, but all that's left is Karamo. So he's like culture, that's like his title on the show, but it's also like psychology and the mental health and social stuff and just everything else. So we're gonna dive into that. So like I said, I've mentioned my Winnipeg trip a couple times. It was really fun, guys. I miss it so much. I had so much, like such a good time in Winnipeg, and it was like the combination of like not worrying about work, not looking at work, hanging out with a friend like basically all the time, and even when I wasn't with her, I was like still like it was just nice to like have just like near constant like access to social, like even if we weren't together, it was like I knew if I needed a person there would be a person there. So just like the access to like a friend all the time was kind of nice. Winnipeg was just like a lovely city. It was just like there was so much to see and so much to do. I said this before I think in my Winnipeg video, but people, especially in Canada, I feel like give Winnipeg a bad rap that's like not necessarily deserved. Like I really, really enjoyed being there, saw really a lot of cool things, like I said, ate really good food. But when I got back, my mental health like tanked, and this is what I mean when I say like I feel like when you go on a trip, you need like a trip, like you need time off to recover from your time off, because it's like the crash afterwards was so bad. Like I got back on the 20th and it's October 6th and I'm only just starting to feel better because I was like so depressed after my trip. Like I fully was like, I just missed it so much, and it was one of the, this happens to me all the time. Like anytime I have like a really, really good like time with people, like even if it's like a day, like if it's like honestly the crash is less long too when it's only like, if I have like one good day with people, the crash doesn't last 2 weeks the way like I had a good week and now my crash is 2 weeks long. But it's like when I have a good time with people, I have like a crash in response to it almost, I feel like, because I don't know, I just feel like I can't like handle really, really good moments, because then my body afterwards is like, okay, well you had this great time and now you don't have it. And it's like I go through almost like this weird like withdrawal thing where I'm like, okay, well now I'm gonna be like horribly depressed and horribly sad because I'm not having that good time anymore. And I think it's because I don't feel like it's like predictable that I'll have it again. Mostly because most of my like really good friends don't live here. So it's kind of like when I do have a really good time with people, I can't reliably count on it happening again, and it makes me really upset. And I feel like if I could reliably count on like, I'm gonna have a day like that every week, maybe not necessarily the same day every week, but I could have it all the time, then I wouldn't feel shitty afterwards because it wouldn't feel like a rarity or something that I have to fight to have. So that's the thing. I spent like yesterday crying, and then I also cried my therapy appointment with Sarah. Cause again, literally I was having like a weird mental health thing, and I was like, yeah, I was just feeling bad about myself and missing friends and just the state of my friendships in general and a lot of things. And it was kind of hard, but onwards and upwards, we're feeling better. I haven't worked out also since I got back from my trip, which now that I realize it's been 2 weeks, it's kind of bad. So I need to get back into that. Cause I even like in Winnipeg sort of maintained it. Like I wasn't doing like good workouts and I wasn't doing them every day, but I did do like 2 workouts while I was there. So I kind of need to like kick myself in the ass and get back on that because I super fell off and I want to get better because I did feel better when I was doing those. I hated it. Like I said in my last Queer Eye update, I kind of was like, I don't like doing this anymore, but I should at least try to get back into doing it at least 3 times a week, even if I'm not going to do the same push to do it every day anymore. Another fun part of being on my trip was I watched so many movies that I've been meaning to watch for a while, and that was really fun. Venom, Christopher Robin, Luca. All movies that I've been wanting to see forever. Oh my God, Kung Fu Panda, which I've never seen. I think I said all this in my Winnipeg video too, so I'm not gonna go into it too in depth. But it was just nice to consume media and not feel like I just didn't have time to do it. I feel like it's weird because I feel like I've mentioned before that I used to have this compulsive need on like all of my social medias, but especially on Tumblr, to see everything that's on my dashboard. So I would scroll back until I hit like the last part I'd seen and made sure I'd seen everything. And it was like really unsustainable and it was a huge time suck, but I would get like the worst like anxiety and like FOMO if I like didn't see everything. And I was just like I said, I had not been able to do it properly for like a month, but I had all those tabs open. But then right before my trip, like right before I left, my like Chrome crashed and I lost all of those tabs and like unrecoverable. Like there was no like reopen closed tabs. Like it's just like they didn't save. So I like lost all of them. And that almost like reset something in my brain where I was like, okay, well fuck it. I can't do this anymore. And I was really anxious about it for a couple days. But then when I was in Winnipeg as well, like I couldn't really do it. So it was just like the kind of thing where I would just like scroll Tumblr for a bit and then close it. Cause I was like, I'm not gonna have time to look at all this. And I've already like lost all those other days. So like, why does it matter? And I feel like it's still like low level stresses me out a bit, but I'm also just getting better at just like, if the tab is still open when I close my computer and go to bed and I wake up the next morning, I just close it and open a new tab if I want to go on Tumblr. And I'm just like, I just write off anything I haven't seen from the day before. It's just like a lost cause. And I still feel like I'm like missing out on like the funniest part of the internet and like the inside joke factory of the internet, because I truly do think the internet's humor all stems from Tumblr. Like nobody who's not still on Tumblr recognizes that like everything funny about the internet comes from Tumblr. Like I fully believe this, and every other website steals from Tumblr like all the time. But yeah, I used to feel like I was missing out on jokes, or like that my mutuals would be like making jokes without me and then I wouldn't get things when I came back. And now I'm just kind of like, it's not that serious, so that's interesting. But I thought like doing that would give me more free time because I wouldn't like be consumed with the need to see everything and then like use and then cut into like my sleep time or whatever to do it. But I haven't developed more time. I think I'm sleeping a little bit better, but I'm still like in my free time, even like I'm still like as busy as I was. Like I don't suddenly have more time for other things like playing video games or like hobbies or whatever, which is like kind of frustrating. Cause I thought I was like, I knew Tumblr was a huge time suck. So I thought like going on it less would give me more time, but I've just like filled that time with other things. Like I feel like I spend more time on YouTube now, just like watching videos. So that's kind of like irritating because I thought that was one of my huge vices, was like the amount of time I spent on the internet, on social media, on Tumblr, and especially on Tumblr. Now that I'm not on Tumblr, I thought I would like suddenly have all this extra free time, but I've just like channeled it into other things. So that's kind of irritating, but I don't know. It's like one step forward. I'm not gonna count it as 2 steps back, but it's just like one of those things where I thought the net benefit of not going to see everything on Tumblr would be more than it was, which it's not really, but I'm also not going to let myself fall back into the trap of needing to see everything because it's dumb to get anxious about it. And the fact that I was getting anxious about it like says enough about how much of a problem it was. I feel like I mentioned grad school a lot on this channel. I still haven't like done the thing I need to do, which is send those emails I need to send. I keep procrastinating, but my roommate, if you're watching this, hi Chelsea, has been doing a lot of grad school stuff. And so I kind of feel like that's the kick in the butt I need to actually at least just send out those emails. Like even if I don't go, I don't even know when I would start, like if it would be January or if it would be like September of 2022, but I think I should just at least like inquire and figure that out and then figure out how much it would cost and how I would do like pay for that. I don't think I have like this, I don't have the savings right now to do like a full thing of grad school. So I don't know, but it's like, I should at least just like send out the emails and ask the questions and even figure out if the program I'm looking at is the right program for what I want to do. And if like the people who are in that program, like the advisors and stuff, like think it's like, it is the right program for me. So I should at least like do that and stop procrastinating. But I'm like a serial procrastinator. Like there's like this, like I literally have been meaning to send these emails for like 3 months and I still haven't, so I should do that. I said last month I was thinking about doing NaNoWriMo. I'm still thinking about doing that, but if I wanted to do that, I'd have to spend this month at least like planning out what I want to write, like at least like roughly drafting the story And I haven't done that, so I would need to do that. Ooh, another unrelated to any of this, but yeah, like I still haven't decided if I want to do an NaNoWriMo, but I am still thinking about it. I think the sales under my story I did have deflated a bit. Like I think I was very hyped about it for like 2 days, and then I kind of like moved on to like not thinking about it. So I would have to like get right back into that headspace and like actually like write things down now that I've thought about them. But I think I was gonna say this month I finally took Luna to her new groomers to get groomed. And it cost a metric fuck ton of money. Like it was like 3 times what I used to pay at PetSmart, but she came out looking really nice. And they seem to like be willing to have her back. So like that's all I can really ask for, is I just want to have her to have like a reliable groomer. And it's not like, since I don't take her every month, so it's not like a huge expense. It's just like in the moment, it's very ouch. But she looked very fly. They gave her a very fun new bandana. So like I'm glad I just got that sorted out. And going there, we went on a very nice long walk, and that neighborhood was really nice. So it was kind of just nice to like wander while I was waiting for her to be done, because it took her like 3 hours. Although I think I would like next time want to go at like, because I went at like, her appointment was at 8 a.m. and none of the stores in that neighborhood opened until like 10 or 11. So I was kind of like just sitting in a Tim Hortons with a book. Reading though, I read a little bit because of that. I read more of that essay book that I've been reading with the music essays. But I would like to go after 10, like have her appointment be at 10 so that I can actually like wander around and like go into stores instead of just like sitting in one spot. But that was the thing I got done, and I'm very proud of myself for finally getting it done. The other thing I've gotten into very recently is like kind of cringe, very embarrassing, but I have gotten roped into Minecraft YouTube because one of my friends, Nay, who I met on Tumblr like forever ago, like I think we met like in a Teen Wolf roleplay or something. Like I don't even remember how I met Nay, but we were Tumblr mutuals for a long time, and now we're Twitter mutuals and Discord friends and just like real life friends. I think we're real life friends. Nay, are we real life friends? I would consider you a friend, Nay. But Nay was reposting like the coolest fan art, and she's been drawing really cool fan art. And I've been seeing this for like months. And like other people I know on Tumblr and follow on Tumblr are like into Minecraft YouTube. And I was like, wait, I know the kids are really into this. Like I know the 14-year-olds are like all over this. And but now the people I am like friends with who are like my age are kind of into this too. And I'm like, okay, well, I need to like see what the hype is about. Cause nobody goes from like under 1 million subscribers to over 25 million subscribers for no reason. Reason, right? So I was like, this has to be, even if it's for children, it has to be like compelling in some way. And Lord forgive me, it's compelling. I'm kind of into it. It's like, it's to the point where it's making me want to actually like play Minecraft, just because like the mechanics of Minecraft look kind of fun. I still don't understand Minecraft. I think it literally is just like you build shit and that's it. But that's always the most fun part of The Sims too, is just building stuff, right? So I think I would enjoy it. And the thing that I think is interesting about Minecraft YouTube that I didn't realize until I watched it was like it scratches the same itch that like listening to like Critical Role scratches, or like playing Dungeons and Dragons, or watching someone else play Dungeons and Dragons scratches. And that like, it's a combination of like people who are really good friends and who really trust each other, just like shooting their shots and having fun and like just making insane narratives up. It's like a D&D game, but without so much of the luck narrative, like the luck elements. Like it's a lot more, like it's obviously improvised, but there's not really like a luck mechanic. It's just like, you roughly plan out plot lines and you execute them in this like live action, or not live action, but you basically LARP in Minecraft pretty much is what it seems to be to me. And it's like fun. Like these guys are like committed to what they're doing, and they have like, unfortunately, like very endearing personalities that make it very fun to watch them play off each other and betray each other and like do these like huge sagas. Anyways, so I'm kind of into the Minecraft YouTube thing, especially Wilbur. So he's, I think, my favorite one so far. I'll be honest, I haven't like fully watched enough videos of everybody else because he's like easily my favorite, just because like, his like character narrative is like very fun. I'm very, if you know anything about me, you know I love the whole like rise and fall and hubris and like epic betrayals and just like being tortured by like your own like mistakes and past and just like the angst of it all. I find very fun. I also just think he's very cute and very tall. So I've been very much enjoying his content. I've been watching like other videos on his YouTube, like his You Laugh, You Lose videos are really good. They make me laugh. His GeoGuessr videos are very fun. I also love geography, so like I also like to just play along with those. And I've also been listening to his music, like both the like satirical, like humorous stuff he does on his under his own name, but also just like his band Lovejoy is like, I really like their EP. I know they have another EP coming out soon, so excited for that. So that's like a new interest of mine. It's like, it's kind of embarrassing, but to be honest, like I'm kind of glad, because prior to that, my hyperfixation interests were like water parks and Supernatural, and both of those things like fandom wise are like hell. And like, I'm not gonna pretend the Minecraft people have better fandoms, just because the fandoms are children and they're also very large. And so I think those two things like combined will like produce like a pretty like insane fandom, but I don't interact with those fandoms. So like the thing, the thing can't be ruined because I haven't delved into the fandom yet. I'm just having my own like good time in the corner, like trying to catch up on the lore of like whatever LARPing they've been doing in Minecraft. I've been enjoying it. It's been very fun. I've also been talking to my therapist, Sarah. We had a very good session the other day where I cried, like I said. And then, but she also like validated my thing that like, A, social media is toxic and terrible and a disease, but also B, that like the way culture glamorizes teenagehood is really toxic because it's like a very unsustainable thing, just both to live through as a teenager, but then also to, once you're beyond that, like once you're no longer like 20 years old or 18 years old or whatever, like once you hit 20, you're like, okay, so like the best part of my life is like over, allegedly, according to media. And so it's like, she like very much like validated my, that I wasn't like insane for having like crises over the fact that I'm not a teenager, even though it's been like literally like 6 years since I was a teenager, almost 7 years. So that was kind of nice and kind of validating. And then going forward, okay, I do have social plans. I'm seeing Venom 2 with some of my Toronto friends on Thanksgiving, and that whole Thanksgiving weekend, I'm seeing my mom one day, and then I have plans on Thanksgiving and the day before with my roommates. So that's gonna be fun. And then like I said, I'm going to see my friend Becca mid-October for like 4 days, I think. I believe it's 4 days, but we're gonna see each other, which is great, because I haven't seen her like since before the pandemic, I think. So it's been a while. So I'm very excited for that. Also, I think I need to watch Squid Game because literally everybody on my timeline is talking about it. And I was worried initially that it would be like a little too gory or like it would freak me out really bad. And I still think it's probably gonna be like upsetting to me, the level of violence, but like literally the way everybody has watched it, I feel like it can't be that bad. Like I feel like the people that are watching it are not like horror buffs on my feed. Like everybody I know has watched it, so I feel like at this point I have to also watch it and see what the hype is all about. It's probably gonna traumatize me, but that's okay. And the other thing I want to say is I've been looking into a lot of different classes, because I feel like, again, I keep saying I want to make new friends and I want to meet new people, and I feel classes are a good way to do that. But all the ones I've looked up are like so much money. It's like $400 for like 5 classes of something, and I'm like, okay, well that's a lot of money that I could probably spend if I like stopped frivolously buying other things, but I'd have to tamp down on one to save up for the other. But then I'm also like, I could also just like, I feel like there surely must be like cheaper options at like community centers that I'm just like not aware exist. So I'm trying to like look into that more, and yeah, I kind of want to sign up for some classes and do some things. That's it. I think that's all for the month. My goals for next month are keep looking into the classes, keep tidying, do all my socializing stuff that I just said I had plans for, like going to see Becca, staying, having all my Thanksgiving plans, not letting any of these things like derail like how I'm doing health-wise. Start working out again, that's a big one. Keep trying new foods, empty the freaking boxes by the door. Like, Seema, please empty those goddamn boxes. It cannot be that hard. Or at least like look through them, see what's even in there. If you can't even empty them, like at least like figure out like what you can empty out and then put everything else like in the storage room or something. Like they don't need to just sit by the door. Yeah, look into the classes at the community center, figure out if you're doing NaNoWriMo, and if so, like start writing your outlines out and like figuring out like the intricacies of your plot. Figure out how you're gonna organize your scrunchies and your jewelry, and even if you don't actually do the organizing, like figure out how you want to do them. Oh, I need to buy a new lighter. That's a unrelated task. It's sort of kind of related to like my environment, just because like my lighter is out, and so I can't light candles, and that like adversely affects my mental health and I can't light candles. So I need a new lighter. And then the other thing I've been thinking about goal wise and I still want to keep doing is I've been thinking for a couple months that I would like to, not instead of YouTube, but next to YouTube, also maybe like stream on Twitch once or maybe twice a week. But that's a thing that is like not gonna happen anytime soon. I'm very much just still thinking about it and thinking about like the kind of content I would want to do. It would definitely be like more like live, not live action, but just like stuff like that I think would be more interesting to watch someone do live, you know, like window shopping online, which is a thing Nisi Pisa does on her channel that I think would be really fun to do live. And I think it would be less of a steal from her if I did it live too. It's obviously all with credit, but I don't want to steal her idea and then also like, I don't do it in the exact same format. So I think doing it live would be cool. I think another thing to do live that would be fun would be just like makeup tutorials, or especially like weird makeup, like following other people's weird makeup tutorials. Like those ones that are like how to turn yourself into a Bratz doll, like trying to do those like live, I think would be really fun to both do and also watch. So that's kind of content I was thinking about doing live, but I have to just like figure it out. Like I don't know anything about streaming on Twitch. The optics of it would be very difficult to set up. Like I'm actually attempting to do research into it. It's not anything that would happen anytime soon. And I also think it would be a good resource in terms of like on weeks where I really don't have ideas or I don't have time to do a whole separate video, I can just like cut Twitch footage, which I know a lot of Twitch people do, is they will then like turn their Twitch content into videos. I wouldn't want that to be the whole thing for my channel. Like I wouldn't want my channel to just be like a repeat of everything that's on Twitch, but I think it would be, I don't know, it'd be a fun thing to explore. So I don't know when I'd be doing that. I don't know when I'd start it, but it's something I have been thinking heavily about. So I don't know, maybe one day. And on that note, I think also I kind of want to like cut like out of context funny moments from my channel and maybe put those on TikTok, because TikTok seems to be the place to be these days. And I still have an account on there, but I feel like I should actually delve into it more because that's where all the kids are. That sounded weird out of context, but you know what I mean? It's like the hip trending platform. So I kind of want to delve into that further as well. So those are my goals. I did this video and it's very late. So without all that being said, I'm sorry I'm talking so fast. I'm really tired. With all that being said, if you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button. If you want to follow me on other social media platforms, you can follow me on Twitter and on Instagram. And if you want to hang out with me on other videos, I post new videos every Wednesday, so please hit that subscribe button, and I will see you guys all next week. Bye!